Oh, buddy.
So I've come into my mum's house today. Because it's right on the river and it's...
Oh! Oh my god! Oh my god!
It's me, Clara A. Vanier, and this is Spirit Mail. So today I wanted to do a sort of inspiring type of video because I wish that someone had said this to me many, many years ago. And so if there's anything that I can offer you guys that is going to be as valuable to you as this would have been for me, then I would have saved myself many, many years procrastinating, feeling guilty, feeling bad, all that kind of bullshit. So today's video is on fixing the unfixable. I know that the things that happen to you are terrible. I know that the things that happen to us throughout our lives are unfair, unjust. I'm sorry that somebody hurt you. I'm sorry that there are evil people in this world. You don't deserve to hurt. You don't deserve to feel the way you do now. But you cannot even begin to imagine where you will be in 1 year from now. I know that if you said to me 5 years ago, you're going to be where I am now. Pain is only temporary if you let it be that way. Your misery is not your identity. Your pain is not who you are. The problem with trauma is that we can cling to it because it feels familiar. We can have a storyline which we run over and over and over again throughout our lives and not let go of because it's become a part of you are stronger and more resilient than you can even begin to imagine. You can't even imagine where you'll be in a year from now. Just know that you don't know. And just keep holding out. There are so many times when I could have given up. And if I did, it doesn't bear thinking about. There are evil people in this world, and I'm so sorry about that. I'm so sorry they hurt you. But don't let them win. Don't let them keep hurting you. As long as you are dragging up the past, and you're bringing up these relics that you've familiarized yourself with over and over again, so much so that it's an impossibility for you to be remaining in the present. As cheesy and cliche as that sounds, like it's actually a thing. Life requires you to be. It requires you to take risks. Doing things differently is a risk. It's fucking scary. But also not doing anything is a risk. Because there is only so long that you can go on clinging to this storyline. There's only so long that you can go on clinging to this pain. And trust me, I know that life without this pain seems, or it feels impossible to imagine. Because you are your, you know, disorder, or you are your disability, or you are your trauma. But you're not. Who are you without all that stuff? That's what I want you guys to cultivate. That's what I think is so important to get to know, you know? You need to stand proudly in who you've become, because what is the alternative? Self-hate? Self-regret? No, don't do that. You are all you've got. And nothing's going to change that. In life, we must face one of two things. The pain of discipline or the pain of regret. The pain of discipline is hard, but the pain of regret is bitter. I say that introspection is the key to greatness. I believe that it is the answer to the questions that so many people are asking, but so few have the patience to actually pursue. I promise you it's not going to be comfortable facing your less desirable assets, your less fabulous attributes. It's not going to be nice. It's not pretty. It's not comfortable. But again, what is the alternative? What else are you going to do? carry on kidding yourself your entire life. You can't do that. We can't do that. Our youth is priceless, if I listen to anything any older person has told me. Why don't we set ourselves up on real foundations? Why don't we know where we're starting from? Most people are literally just wanking their life away. In an attempt to escape their own company. How much have you achieved in terms of really getting to know yourself? Are you still going to be proud of how much you've achieved in 5 years? This is the third eye message for today. Work like no one now, so you can live like no one later. Do the self-work now, whilst you're young, whilst it matters, whilst you still have your whole future in front of you. Back in 2015, I wrote it in my brain book, Clara, flex your life muscle. And I have, I did. In 2015, I so nearly met my end. Right there and then I decided no more. Time to switch it up. I wouldn't want to sit in front of little Clara, 6-year-old Clara, say, and have her look at me and me tell her I'm giving up, because what that person did was too painful. Little Clara would be like, what the fuck? And she would be like, what the hell? Don't let the bastards get you down, right? So true. How could I ever know what my dreams are if I don't even know myself? I pursued getting to know myself like I would pursue, you know, the career of my dreams. And I had to have some really fucking horrible realizations. I had to come up against how lazy I was, how non-introspective I was, full of bullshit I was. But because now I'm coming to properly know in my bones who I am, no one or nothing can take that from me. If you're somebody who finds it really hard to accept being loved, for example, who doesn't love themselves enough to be able to accept that somebody else loves them without sort of, you know, getting freaked out by it, you need to identify the root cause of that pain. You need to understand where that pain comes from, why it is that you are that way inclined. Knowing yourself is to know the world, to properly understand who you are, why you are that way, what made you that way. It's the master key to life. Nothing beats it. That's all from me. I love you guys. Love yourself.